what we're going to do is called conscious manifestation. So I'm actually going to teach you how to manifest on purpose, to manifest what it is that you want. So to create what you want in the physical form. Kathleen Cameron here, Chief Manifestation Success Coach of Diamond Academy. I am here today in my beautiful kitchen to talk to you about manifestation for beginners. So of course, like anything, there's always foundational things that you can learn that are easy to connect with, easy to understand, and you can always dig deeper. So today I'm going to give you my 7 tips for beginners to help you to start thinking about manifesting what you want instead of manifesting what you don't want. So my very first tip, okay, and these are in sequential order. So you need to do numbers 1 to 7 in this order to be able to create a manifestation for yourself. The first thing I want to let you know though is that you know how to manifest, you are already doing it. But what we're going to do is called conscious manifestation. So I'm actually going to teach you how to manifest on purpose, to manifest what it is that you want. So to create what you want in the physical form. So in really, really clear, easy to understand language, manifesting is simply taking an idea and bringing it into the physical form. For me, I see it as a spiritual idea. So it's an idea, a picture that I'm creating in my imagination first, in the spiritual form, and I'm bringing it into the physical form. So the first step is to ask for what you want. So in order to ask for what you want, you have to know what it is you want. So this is like putting in your order to the pizza place when you're ordering a pizza, or putting in your order in Amazon Prime, except we talk about it as Universe Prime. So you have to say what it is that you want. Is it a certain type of house, a certain type of business, a certain amount of money? What would you do with that money? Is it certain types of relationships in your life? This is where you have to get really specific about what it is you want in your life. Not what other people want you to want, but what you actually want. The next tip or step in this manifestation process is to believe. So the really interesting thing here is that we ask for things all the time and we believe that we are going to get them. Without a shadow of a doubt, we know that it's gonna happen. So an example that I can give you that's really easy to follow is putting a pot on the stove, beautiful stove behind me, and turning on the high heat, putting the pot of water on and walking away. You believe that when you come back, that pot will be boiling water. It's the same thing when you put a cake in the oven at 350, that you're gonna come back to almost or fully cooked cake. It's the same thing with ordering something off Amazon. So we'll use this analogy of Amazon Prime, Universe Prime. So it's asking for what you want and just believing that it's on its way. So the biggest thing here is managing doubt. So whenever we think that something is hard to believe, unbelievable, impossible, unlikely, unrealistic, whenever we apply those words, we're taking away the power in the actual thing that we're asking for. So we're gonna manage the doubt, we're gonna remove all of those words, and we're gonna believe that what we want is on its way, that it is inevitable, that it is possible, that it is attainable, achievable. Whatever word is gonna convince you that you can have it, that is the frame of mind that you need to stay in for your manifestations to show up in the physical world. So the next one, the third step for you to build the foundation. So you are gonna ask, you're gonna believe, and you're gonna let go. So what are we gonna let go of? We're gonna let go of all the things that show up as resistance. So you order a pizza, you're waiting for it to come, you're checking the door every 5 minutes, you're calling the pizza place saying, it's not here yet, where is it? I don't believe it's coming, I don't see it. That is all resistance, that is not letting go. So you wanna make sure that you're asking, you believe that it's on its way, and that you let go of any of those things that are gonna be creating that feeling of, I'm not quite sure it's gonna happen. So have you ever heard the saying, a watched pot never boils? This is what it means. You're not gonna watch it, you're gonna let it go, you're gonna have fun with it. You're gonna put it into the vortex, you're gonna walk away, and you are going to be so excited when it shows up for you. faith is one of my favorite things to talk about because it is the basis of all success. So one of my favorite authors, Dr. Robert Russell, he says that success is faith expressed in action. So this is the fourth tip for manifestation, is that you have to have faith, you have to have a trust that this thing that you want, this lifestyle, is on its way to you and that you are worthy of it. So when you act in a way of faith, you do certain things. So if you know that the pizza's on its way, you're putting the cutlery on the table, you're getting the glasses, you're getting out the napkins, you're preparing for when that pizza arrives. So this is what faith is. Faith is doing the physical things in your now, in anticipation of those things showing up in the physical world. So go set your table, get your glasses ready, and prepare yourself for the manifestation to show up in the physical world now. This saying comes to me all the time, and it's because it's so, so good. Patience is a virtue. I can't say this enough. You need to have patience. We are not going to be looking for it. We're not going to be asking for it. We're not going to be in a state of doubt and worry and fear that it's not coming. We aren't going to be in this place where we're constantly give, 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 where, help, help, help. We're going to be in a place where we just know that it's on its way and we have patience. So we're going to continue to ask and release. We're going to let go. We're going to believe, but we're going to stay in a place of patience. It's in the moments of impatience that we reverse and we start asking for what we don't want again. So when we say it's not here yet, the dominant feeling is that it's not here. So what you're asking for is more not here. So don't allow yourself to go to that place. I often see myself as a flowing river, and I like to see my mind and my body as a flowing river. So what does that mean? I like to think of energy flowing to and through me, nice and clean, fast, no resistance. So I always make sure that I'm in a state of receiving. And when you're in a state of receiving, it's when you're wide open and your channel is flowing quickly. Your river is flowing quickly. So things that show up for me that are resistance are things like stress, sadness, negativity, doubt, worry, indecision-based programming. So I make sure that I really, really make sure that none of that is present in my life and that I am in a beautiful state of gratitude and joy and of love. So the best way to manifest something into your physical now is to be so incredibly grateful for what you already have. Because then your point of attraction is bliss, is happiness. So that's what you're gonna bring more of into your life. So gratitude can be so incredibly important in the manifestation process. Gratitude for what you physically have now, but gratitude for the ideas that are in the fourth dimension that are on their way to the physical now for your incoming manifestations. The last step is just to repeat. So we're gonna repeat all of those things over and over again. But I want you to be repeating these steps in a fun way. What if this works? What if I start having things show up in my life that I'm asking for that I never thought I could have? What if I can change my entire world just by changing my thinking? There's so much fun in this. Try it as an experiment to see what happens. No pressure, only fun. And the other thing that I will say, and this is one of the things that has changed everything for me, is that my desire for more is greater than my fear. So if you have a fear that this isn't gonna work, I want you to push that aside, I want you to have some fun, and I want you to try manifesting something into your physical world that you will be so incredibly grateful for, and you'll be thanking me later.